I'm Nicholas Martin. During 1993, I was given the opportunity of visiting Australia to play a number of theatre organ concerts. I was fortunate in being invited to make the video recording on one of the finest instruments that I've played, the Wurlitzer organ, which is situated now in the Orion Centre in Campsie, a suburb of Sydney. The organ was shipped from Wurlitzer's North Tonawanda factory in the USA and installed originally in the Capitol Theatre in Sydney. This was in 1928. And it remained in use until falling attendances forced the management to cut costs, as in so many theatres worldwide. The organ was removed from the cinema in Sydney in 1972, and it was stored then by the Theatre Organ Society of New South Wales until they found a suitable home for it. They found this home in 1988, and of course it's the Orion Centre here in Campsie, and the organ really now is quite impeccable. It really is a joy to play. It's a super respect. Every stop works on the machine, and if I can just give you a brief demonstration of some of the effects over here. On the solo keyboard, for example, we have chimes, we have a carillon, and we have such things as glockenspiel, and also xylophone, chrysoglot, And then we have a piano attachment, upright piano attachment over there as well. We have on the accompaniment the non-tonal percussions, such as tambourine and castanets, Chinese block. And then if we move down to the feet, we have such things as the steamboat whistle. And we have the fire bell there as well. So as you can see, they've got all the effects on these machines, and we know that they were originally installed in the cinemas for accompaniment of the silent movies. But around about the time when they were put into the movie houses, the talking pictures just about came in. So then they started to use them in between the films and at the start of the show and what have you. So it was a bit of a change around there. But now this organ has found itself in a proper place of entertainment, and it's doing all sorts of things here, dances, concerts, and carol shows, and it's really being put to some good use, which is ideal for it, of course.
2 weeks ago today, and then I went on to Tasmania and did a concert in a girls' school. My goodness, that was good for my time, yes. And then I went on to Adelaide, did a concert at the Capri there, and I've come to Sydney, and all the audiences have been really so marvellously enthusiastic. It really has been great for me to witness everything. So let me just tell you that when I was at Perth, the very first concert this was, at the end of the afternoon, the audience was so impressed that many of them stood up. And it wasn't until after the show that I found that I'd been playing to the Perth branch of the Hemorrhoid Society. Yes. I thought it was a standing ovation, but it wasn't. Shows you how long it can be.
Dancing has long been associated with the Blackpool style of playing, and Sydney audiences turned out to enjoy Nick's dance tempos at the Orion Centre Wurlitzer.
Thank you.
Very well done. Right, and I've also had a request from some young ladies that used to reside in England, and they've asked for this one, the St. Bernard's Waltz. Anyone else know that one? Yeah? Yeah? A Donny Mitchell, yes. Donny the Dance, yes.
Some classical music is always appreciated during a concert, and the Vidor Toccata demonstrates both Nick's command of the console and the capabilities of the Orion organ.
Thank you.
Right, we'll move on. We have a couple more numbers for you now. And we'll do you a bit of a train sequence now. I know we can get a fairly authentic steam train effect out of the organ. But just watch yourselves on the front row here, won't you? Because it might blow you away. But we'll do this for my last selection. Thank you very much indeed for coming, and I look forward to our triumphant return here some sunny day. So, till then, take care of yourselves.